very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th December, on the front page you have Supreme Court flags delay in appointment of judges. So Supreme Court bench has sought details on 213 names pending with government and collegium. So there are 213 names recommended for appointment to various high courts, and these names are pending with the government or the Supreme Court collegium. And the Supreme Court has noted this down in a judicial order. So delay in appointment of judges results in benches being left there are number of vacancies being high. You can see the percentage of vacancies here in various states, and because of this the pendency of cases also increases, which is already high. There are accumulated number of cases and they have to be disposed of at a quicker pace rather than having so many vacancies. So this is a major cause of concern. Then here you have violence march protests against citizenship bill. So this is violent protests in Tripura. Internet SMS services have been suspended here, and these protests are against the citizenship amendment bill. So we have seen in Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram, which are four states mentioned under 6th schedule of the constitution. Here in these states, scheduled areas are protected. So protests here have been spearheaded by Northeast Students Organization. So here you can see other Northeastern states, actually all Northeastern states have been protected from citizenship amendment bill, except some regions of Assam and Tripura. So either they are under the 6th schedule or under the inner-light permit regulation. Here also protests still continue. On page 4 you have capital takes steps to help India better its ease of business ranking. So government bodies have taken the online route to achieve higher position in the World Bank report. So to improve India's position in World Bank's ease of doing business, these are the steps being taken, going online. So it's ease of doing business, increasing number of procedures, the time taken and the cost as such reduces, the quality increases, and the ranking has increased. Because under World Bank's ease of doing business, you should know that two cities are taken as samples and audits are done, and these are Mumbai and Delhi. So what the government does is it improves procedures here in Mumbai and Delhi. On page 9 you have Google liable for defamation cases before act change. So this is what the Supreme Court has said, that Google faces action for defamatory content published by third parties. So this is the ruling of the Supreme Court. You should know that on October 27, 2009, the Parliament amended the Information Technology Act of 2000 to protect online intermediaries from liability for criminally defamatory content published in them by third parties. So this amendment came in 2009, the 2000 Act. So Supreme Court says before that the cases are not protected from criminal defamation, and here those cases can be heard. So this is a shock ruling of the Supreme Court for Google. So this is specifically about section 79 of the Act. So did not protect an intermediary in regard to offense under section 499-500 of IPC. And here you have amid complaints, farmers body to revise guidelines. So this is regarding Gujarat farmers and PepsiCo. So PepsiCo has cited the FAQ section to justify cases filed by it. So this is regarding plant varieties and farmers rights authority. So this is the body, protection of plant varieties and farmers right authority, and is an act by this name. So Gujarat potato farmers have been protesting, and PepsiCo India has also been raising its claims, and both have been referring to the same provisions of the Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers' Rights Authority Act. So then who is correct, whether the farmers' rights are protected or PepsiCo's rights are protected was not clear. And in this, PepsiCo has raised the point of FAQ, that in the frequently asked questions document on the website, it is written that only small and marginal farmers involved in subsistence farming are eligible to claim rights under the Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers' Rights Act of 2001. So based on this, PepsiCo says that they are correct, and Gujarat farmers should not grow their Lay's variety of potatoes elsewhere and should not sell it elsewhere. Then this is India proposes extended deadline for commitments at climate summit. So India has proposed that developed countries make good commitments on providing finance to developing countries by 2023 instead of 2020. So we have asked for extension of this deadline. So developed countries have not met Kyoto Protocol targets too. So this is under Paris Agreement, the successor to Kyoto Protocol. On the editorial page, the first editorial is instant reward. So this is regarding Karnataka. The bipoles were held here, by elections, and in this we saw that BJP had given tickets to rebel MLAs from Congress and JDS, and they won on BJP's ticket. So BJP has comfortable majority in Karnataka too. Earlier it was Congress JDS coalition which was ruling in Karnataka, but then because of these rebel MLAs quitting, BJP could form the government and Congress JDS government fell. So Supreme Court ruling came now, and elections which upheld that they are disqualified. They were disqualified on charges of defection by the speaker, but for fresh elections they are eligible. This was a Supreme Court ruling as against speaker ruling in defection case that they should not be eligible for fresh elections too. So Supreme Court said they can fight contest fresh elections, and they did so. By elections were held and they won. So now this is instant reward. So it says Karnataka gets political stability even though it was achieved via dubious means. So they have been given berths also now. And this year you have doping to win. So this says that some athletes do cheat, but when they do so with official sanction, it is an epic crisis. So this is regarding the decision of WADA, World Anti-Doping Agency, to ban Russia from global sporting events for 4-year period, in arguably the biggest sporting crisis the country has faced till date. So Russia would be hurt. It would not be able to participate in the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games too, and 2022 Beijing Winter Olympics too. So the national flag, the name and anthem will not be allowed. So Russia will approach the Court of Arbitration for Sports in this issue in appeal. And here you have the lead article, a patently unconstitutional piece of legislation. So this is regarding Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019. It says it has sinister political logic, the first de jure attempt towards a Hindu Rashtra. So we claim to be a Hindu Rashtra, as BJP claims to be a Hindu Rashtra, and the Hindu minorities should be given asylum here, given citizenship here. So that's the idea behind this bill, that only Hindu minorities would be taken in, not all persecuted minorities. And this is wholly subordinated to the majoritarian nation. So this is regarding, but yeah, there is one more thing, not just Hindu minorities, but others have been included. So that is a cover given that not just Hindus, but other minorities from other communities, like Sikhs, Parsis, they have also been included, Jains. Then this is wholly subordinated to the majoritarian nation. So this is regarding National Register of Citizens and Citizenship Amendment Bill. Both together, it says, seeks to reconstitute Indian nationhood on the lines of V.D. Savarkar's idea that we become a Hindutva nation. Then on OPED page you have, this is regarding chess, India's first grandmaster, V. Anand, Vishwanathan Anand. So he says chess players don't necessarily have photographic memory. So it's a book by him, so that's not important. Then this is Iraq's autumn of discontent. So this is regarding the protests going on in Iraq by the disgruntled youth. So India can help Iraq create institutions which connect with the aspirations of the youth is what this article talks of, India's role in Iraq. And this is Congress and partition. So when the facts are placed here regarding partition on religious lines, so the idea came from Hindu Mahasabha and the Muslim League, not from Congress. Then on page 12 you have RBI didn't stop SBI role in poll bonds. So this is regarding electoral polls. So question, electoral bonds. So the questions were raised in the House, and Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, she informed the Rajya Sabha on the matter that RBI did not was involved in consultation process, but it didn't stop SBI, State Bank of India, which is the bank which issues electoral bonds. And this is Lok Sabha nod for bill extending SC/ST quota in state legislators. So MPs call for continuing nomination of Anglo-Indians too. So we have been seeing regarding this. This is the 126th constitutional amendment bill which extends SC/ST quota for 10 more years, but not for Anglo-Indians. Anglo-Indians are nominated, that is one fact. SC/ST get reservation in elections. Then on page 13 you have Nagaland brings ILP in Dimapur. So November 21, 1979 is now the cutoff date for people from outside, and Nagaland government has extended inner line permit system to Dimapur, the commercial hub of the state. And this is US panel recommends sanctions against Amit Shah. So in wake of passage of citizenship amendment bill in Lok Sabha, now US International Commission on Religious Freedom has expressed concern over it and considered recommending sanctions against Home Minister Amit Shah and other top leaders. It says bill sets a legal criteria for citizenship based on religion. On international page you have Trump to face two impeachment charges. So Democrats in the House of Representatives are accusing him of abusing power and obstructing Congress. So both with respect to dealings with Ukraine. So first, he abused his power to ask Ukraine to initiate criminal proceedings against his presidential bid competitor from Democrat Party, the rival, political rival, and Joe bid as such. And another one was with respect to obstructing the Congress, obstructing the Parliament in conducting the impeachment proceedings. So he tried to interfere in the process. And this is Suu Kyi in ICJ to defend Myanmar in genocide case. So this is Aung San Suu Kyi, Nobel Peace Prize winner, who is now in International Court of Justice defending her country Myanmar on the Rohingya genocide case. Gambia's team, which has initiated the case, has detailed mass rapes, burning alive of families in this genocide crisis in Myanmar against Rohingyas. And below you have US, Saudi Arabia at bottom of climate class. So for the first time, India ranks among the top 10 in terms of performance. So this is Climate Change Performance Index, which measures the emissions, renewable energy share and climate policies of 57 countries and the European Union. So here you can see India is among the top 10. US ranks last, and followed by Saudi Arabia and Australia in reverse order. Then on business page you have SBI underreported 12,000 crore non-performing assets. So this has been found by through an inspection. So here you can see it is RBI's inspection report which finds that SBI underreported non-performing assets. So this divergence leaves bank with 6,968 crore loss in financial year 2019 versus profit reported earlier. And this is notional loss in BPCL. BPSCL sale plan at 4.5 lakh crore. So assets worth over 9 lakh crore are there. So Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, the state owned oil firm, public sector undertaking, it will be sold off. So there will be notional loss is what has been stated, which will not be actually incurred by the government. This is called notional loss because the loss is of 4.46 lakh crores, but its total assets exceed 9 lakh crores. So this is what Public Sector Officers Association said. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.